The light is different now. Early spring evening. Cold metal begins to stretch. Our bell towers of Thomas and Patrick speak to each other across the liberties. The music of the spires spills a chorus of workers, locals, onto the streets. I am walking slowly between their notes to meet friends. Here, the red brick of the old town pushes back against the glass of the obedient city. Two local women talking along these broken paths of language thread a sharp elongation of the vowel sound with a little diphthong and the dismissive yet caring farewell of go on. The wall fallen rest on the concrete. Capuchins serve soup kitchen honesty. There's a march on Saturday and I want to head in, but the kid has a thing and rebellions need childcare. The Lord and Lady watches on the street of antiques. Stone fixed stairs guard the door to a labyrinth of ivy consuming the market. It will provide unless it's left to rot. The sound of hooves echoes off the lane at Monaloo Yard towards the old distillery brewing new abstractions. The pony boys and girls doing a famous five ride into a battle for survival. Graffitied walls tell the tale of struggle. It starts with the spark of art and continues with resistance. There is a gap to the presence in the skyline. The district needs its bite. Into this absence, the young creators paint murals that valorize, exalt the beauty, the labor, the reality. This working class community will not be denied. The artists rightfully demand a place at the table if Dublin is to be Versailles. In the Italian chipper, there's a slick lad with a party to go to. What you know about McGruder's and the class of 07? The hopes of gone heroes projected onto stabilized walls. Too little, too many. Dreams stamped into cigarette-borne carpets and falling down function rooms where noses and friendships were broken, mended. Every generation came here and lived a different type of glorious youth. And they were there. Coolest of kids. You coming? You mad? Nappies and deadlines to deal with. A little pang in my chest, throwing soil on my youth. A voice note of a baby's cry, a swell in the heart for this world I have gained. It starts with the spark of art and continues with an idea. That a city belongs to all of the people who call it their home. And you cannot sell what you do not own.